When I see that you are both straight and ready, I will start you like this.
Second semi-final.
Attention.
Prince of Wales Challenge Cup.
Go.
Club ready, quadruple please. Skulls. Leander Club on the left, Cardiff University's Sir William Borlase on the right.
Attention. Go.
So the defending champions in this event, the Prince of Wales Challenge Cup, Leander Club on the left of your picture, coming out through 5 out of 10, 100 metres sprinting off here, a crew on a mission, because these guys are perhaps the favourites, the defending champions. They've won this event for the past 5 years in a row, looking to make it 6 in a row here. But Cardiff University, Sir William Borlase, composite crew on the right, themselves a selected crew, coached by Dan Harris. Well, they are making sure that Leander are not having it all their own way. Two top crews here.
Absolutely. It's obviously Leander's home water. This is seems like the millionth Leander crew to come down the stream this week. But they are the defending champions, and of course they're in such a hotbed of talent in Leander. These are all guys fighting for seats in the under-23s, or maybe with aspirations for the national team with the Olympics coming up next year in Rio, looking for that talent identification. And obviously they're just pushing and pushing here, and perhaps are just sneaking away a few inches a stroke.
On the far side, Leander Club, defending champions, easing out to half a boat length now as we move towards the barrier. And a name to watch out for, Jack Beaumont in the three seed here. What a season he has been having. He subbed in at the European Championships for Great Britain in the men's heavyweight quadruple scull. Medaling there. He's looking to make it a hat-trick here in this event, winning 2 times previously. And a name that we will have to watch out for in the future. Angus Groom, his partner, under 23 medalists. Names for the future, both of them. Pete Beaumont is Jack's dad. Back in 1988, I think if I remember rightly, in 88, Great Britain Racing in the composite crew won the grand. Jack's dad, Pete Beaumont, won the grand by about a foot, if my memory serves me right.
A foot is as good as a mile at the end of the day.
History books will say he was the winner.
It just hurts a lot more. Okay, but you can see Cardiff is really rowing a little bit higher, just trying to stay in contention. You just don't want to give up too much open water in a match race.
Wonderful crowds. Look at that here. That's what Henley Royal Regatta is all about on this Saturday evening. Out here watching this fantastic display here. And the Prince of Wales Challenge Cup, the event for top club quadruple sculls, but all of these on both boats vying for international colours and representation over the next couple of years.
Look at the cerise oars of Leander are just very, very precise. Almost like a hot knife through butter. It's nice and clean, very little white water. Putting on a fine display of sculling with the packed banks today.
So they've got clear water now for Leander, but they'll keep moving on here. Showing that they are race favorites. Coached by Mark Banks. Doing a phenomenal job there as head coach at Leander Club over the last few years. Remember Mark being one of the coaches back in the day in 87, the juniors, when I first made the team as in the boys junior eights. Mark was in there, one of the coaches, inspirational coach, continues to do a fantastic job for Leander Club, bringing these boys right up onto the boil here. This is the semi-final of the Prince of Wales Challenge Cup here. As we look at Andrew Joel, Harry Leask, Jack Bowman, Nick Middleton.
They're still keeping their rating up, but it's a nice, relaxed stroke. Reaching out, really pushing with the hips into the headwind. Now they've settled in almost the middle of the course. They don't want to have any trouble with the booms.
Really difficult position to be in now, though, for Cardiff University and Sir William Borlase, because at this stage, you'd have looked over, the bowman would have taken a little peek here. knowing that it's more than 2-3 lengths of clear water, it's all about pride here.
Yes. They'll be continuing to press along, looking good for the people in the stewards' enclosure, those that are actually watching. It's Pim's time almost at 6 o'clock.
Into the head breeze, they're coming up to the general enclosure about a minute or so, give or take, out from the line.
So they just passed the mile mark. They have about 40 strokes. Xander rowing in the low 30s, just sculling along. They still have a race tomorrow on their hands. It's unusual to see so many British crews wearing sunglasses. They must have gotten bought them this morning or this week with this bright sun.
We've just had phenomenal weather here. It's been a real delight for all of our overseas visiting crews, seeing Henley at its very best, its very finest.
And these camera shots are absolutely phenomenal. You just can't get this in a normal regatta. There just aren't the booms, there aren't the boxes, there isn't the proximity of the crews. This will really be a great boom for rowing. For the fans and the young kids to see how fun rowing is.
Tight sculling blades from Leander Club on the left. As the blades go in, they leave the boat pass, legs down in unison. They command this semi-final now. Under control here, metronomic in their movements, the hands away, the bodies follow over. A top club crew, all of which will be at senior international level over the next couple of years. Plenty of spectators appreciating what they're seeing here.
Past the progress board. Coming up to the final 10 strokes.
McMiddleton just looking for the line. He's in the two seat. There it is. Over. Job well done. Through to the final. One more race, and Leander will have made it 6 in a row. So we see Cardiff University and Sir William Borlase just over the line. They'll be hugely, hugely disappointed with that.